Ladies and gentlemen, welcome on in. This is the Fight Night event here at UFC, the main event here. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for some action here at UFC at T-Mobile Arena, ladies and gentlemen? And here we go to the arena for this matchup.
Up next, we get to this middleweight bout between Robert Whittaker and Kelvin Gastelum. Well, he is one of the best fighters on this UFC roster, top to bottom, to have never realized a piece of UFC gold. Former Ultimate Fighter winner Kelvin Gastelum. And some of you like to say, embrace the grind. He has absolutely embraced it. He's embraced the sprints. Seems to have this champion's mentality, and he'll try to parlay that into another big win here tonight.
And he's going to need that mentality in order to build himself back to where he wants to be. But couple that mentality with the skill that Kelvin Gastelum possesses. He's a fantastic boxer. For a short guy, he does a really good job with his kicks. Just a full-on mixed martial artist, a young man that has developed that fighting style from the very start. Truly, truly phenomenal fighter, a great ambassador for the sport. Kelvin Gastelum has it all.
And maybe his best skill is something you can't quantify, his heart.
He's got so much heart. He's got so much heart.
Proudly representing Sydney, Australia, he was born in New Zealand. Robert the Reaper Whittaker. He has put together one of the greatest winning streaks in the history of this middleweight division and did to Yoel Romero what few men have been able to do.
Few men can stand across from Romero and just even live to tell the story right. of fighting him in the octagon. Robert Whittaker has done that twice and gotten his hand raised in the rematch. Whittaker is a truly, truly phenomenal mixed martial artist, has a traditional background, but he also has a wrestling knowledge that is very underrated. He does not just get taken down, he's able to get back to his feet very well, and he has cardio for days. He's truly one of the best fighters in the entire UFC.
And he's a grappler at his core. We talk so much about his boxing, but the guys at Gracie Jiu-Jitsu at Smeaton Grange will tell you, this guy started as a grappler, still grapples in the gi during training camp. Robert Whittaker, back in, ideally in a big way for him here tonight. Our tale of the tape for this, our main event of the evening. The American is 28, the Australian is 29. He will have a 2-inch reach advantage. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Herb G. This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas. It's time! 5 rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a wrestler holding a professional record of 17 wins, 6 losses, and 1 no contest.
He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 185 pounds.
Fighting out of Yuma, Arizona, USA, Kelvin Gastelum.
And now introducing his opponent, fighting at the red corner.
This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 23 wins, 5 losses.
He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Sydney, Australia, Robert Whittaker!
They touch him up and we are underway.
Oh,
right, so here we go. This highly anticipated fight is now underway. Looks like a classic matchup of striker versus grappler. Am I simplifying things too much?
In this instance, you aren't, because this is what got these two men to the show.
Right.
One guy is known for his diverse attack on the feet. The other guy is known for his ability to drag the fight to the mat and put his opponents in danger from the very start of the grappling exchange.
With that jab attempt there. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands.
Oh! Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Slips the punch.
He got him.
Oh, knee strike right to the body. It and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Whitaker. Under 3 minutes now to go in the round.
Big leg kick land.
Connects with the punch there. Right hand upstairs. Wow!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
By that leg kick, may not be a bad idea to start to check some of these. Man, how about the steam behind that Whitaker jab?
Robert Whitaker is a great striker. He has it all when it comes to stand up and boxing. And that is a cool display right now. Oh, nice jab.
Kelvin Gastelum. Oh, tags him with the straight. Nice job there by Gastelum.
Look at the whip action that comes from that kick.
Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish though, because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
That was a jab! 20 seconds left.
That's a big strike right there.
Whoa! Huge elbow there.
Knocked down, but not out. Let's look back at some of the highlights, DC. A huge round on the other side.
He had him hurt very bad. He followed the shot. He got exactly what he wanted. When he saw the opening, he jumped on it, and he hurt his opponent very bad. If he could get back to that one more time, he may end the night.
All right, round two now, ladies and gentlemen. Robert Whitaker versus Kelvin Gastelum.
Superman punch lands!
What a punch. Nice head kick.
Oh, great striking from Robert Whitaker as usual. This man puts some serious pressure on you. When you can beat Yoel Romero the way he did, he is not going to be intimidated by any other 185-pounder in the world.
Oh!
Serve him up. Go get him.
Nice one.
Oh, big left.
They're going at it now.
Oh, straight right. Oh, big left hook there.
Nice punch by Gastelum. So 40 total strikes already have landed for Kelvin Gastelum. And connecting at a 44% clip tonight, DC, against Robert Whitaker. Into the midsection there. Well, he has really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive than we saw in round one, and now starting to find himself. ankle. Nice punch there by Gastelum. Oh, huge kick to the body. Back and forth we go.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this
one? That right hand hurt him a little bit.
All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie. Critical takedown here. Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire.
Right now, it looks like he may be trying to set up an arm triangle choke. He needs to secure the left arm, push it across, and secure it with his head. He needs to push the arm to the side. Get his head against the mat. Now watch as he goes to the finish. Watch his chest go to the mat. He goes flat, all weight. Just, oh, he might have got it with a choke.
The sheer will is really remarkable to watch. Ooh, right into side control, DC.
This is where you want to be now because you get to make your opponent decide. They try to turn back into you. You can attack guillotine. If they turn away to try to get to your knees, you throw your hooks in and you got all your rear choke position. There he is. He's moving to the finishing position. Now watch, he goes parallel right next to his opponent. When it's time to finish, he has to go flat, chest to the mat. There it is. Chest to the mat. Pressure goes down. He'll start to take the air from his opponent.
So here we are as our next round gets underway. I would attack for that previous round, by the way. I would attack.
It was so tight. I cannot believe that he got out of that submission attempt.
Well, he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. He continues to connect on a high volume of strikes here.
Great punch. What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish his fight.
Oh, he might be out. He's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
All right, he's got him in the north-south position now, DC. We'll see if the crowd can be mature about this.
Yes, they have to be mature about the fact that this is a real fighting position and the guy on top has a lot of opportunities to finish. Going to attack this north-south choke. He's got to drive that shoulder deep into his neck, really start to sink his weight away, which will in turn cut the oxygen from his opponent, allowing him to get the pin.
73 total strikes have landed for Kelvin Gastelum. Just below 50% now, landing with 47% accuracy against Robert Whittle. Leading from the eyebrow area now, that shot cut him. All right, well, he's landed some good shots tonight, but there's no three-peat.
Wow! He's hurt bad.
Looked like it did stop a little bit. Well, he's up. But he is certain for certain the finish could come at any time. Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? Just misses with the right. Just an absolutely gorgeous shot to spell the end for his opponent. Crowd is absolutely loving it. He gets the near-perfect land. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming, but just the way he drew it up here tonight, saw that little crack of an opening and barged right through it to get the knockout. Now hard to perform much better than he did tonight. A huge knockout under the lights. They'll be talking about that one for some time.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 51 seconds of the third round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Kelvin Gastelum.
And there is the man of the moment, and what a moment this must be like for a professional athlete, right? I know you enjoyed the birth of your kids, right?
Yeah.
But you knock out a man in a cage fight, I can't think of anything better.
I mean, there's nothing like it. You know, you don't even hear the one that lands that puts out your opponent's lights. And tonight he got that done. And he should be very proud of the work he and